day four of reInvent 2021 here in Las Vegas. Melissa, how are you?
I'm as powerful and efficient as a Graviton 3 processor. In other words, I got some great sleep last night. So, Rudy, what's the football team of the day?
Well, it's the Raiders. I mean, we are here in Las Vegas after all.
Wrong sport, wrong team. In Ajax, Amsterdam's home soccer team. It's Ajax Amsterdam's home soccer team, I should say. And the favorite team of today's keynote host, Amazon's own CTO, Dr. Werner Vogels.
Ah, I wonder what t-shirt he will be sporting this year. I'm hoping for a return to my roots, the Black Sabbath.
You can hope. But before we ponder Werner's wardrobe choices, I want to highlight a bit of what we heard yesterday from Swami and Peter. If there is a theme that has run across everything we've seen this week, it's that data is being generated by every kind of organization and growing massively. As Swami said, data is the key to improving all kinds of machine learning models, and data is increasingly going to make the difference in everything we do.
If you look at what's powering the ML revolution, it is all about how customers are reinventing their business with data. Data is the underlying force that fuels the insights and the predictions that helps you make better decisions and spur completely new innovations. Data is already proliferating through organizations like never before, arriving from everything from smartphones to smart cities, and it is growing so rapidly. In fact, experts believe the term zettabyte, which is the equivalent of 1 billion exabytes, is soon going to be commonplace in the corporate technology lexicon.
Okay, Mr. Diagram. I know a zettabyte is equal to sextillion bytes. So help us visualize that.
Well, see, look, we've got 1 megabyte, and 1,000 megabytes is a gigabyte. Then we've got 1,000 gigabytes being a terabyte. Then we've got 1,000 terabytes being a petabyte. 1,000 petabytes being an exabyte, and 1,000 exabytes being a, you guessed it, zettabyte. But I mean, for those of you wondering, I'm just drawing circles. I mean, look, you know.
Thanks for that.
Okay. Well, let's just leave it at that. A zettabyte of data is a whole lot more than several boatloads of data. All I can say is, don't be a data hog. And Swami made the point that if your company or organization is really going to thrive in this machine learning and data-driven world, it won't just be via technical chops. But there are cultural shifts that we need to happen as well.
On the culture side, you have to overcome data silos and what I call as data hugging. And you got to start treating data like an organizational asset. Companies generate a ton of data, but it is often untapped because companies don't really think of that data as a real asset that can generate new value. And when it is treated the right way, it is no longer the property of an individual department. And data producers are able to share their data in a responsible, secure way to the people that need it so that they can innovate and drive your business.
You gotta share your data. In fact, wait, we're getting some data in that Melissa's outfit looks like half a tomato. But before that, data needs more friends too.
And I need better friends, apparently. And it goes deeper too. A data-driven organization often requires cultural change as well.
Executives, they must champion data-driven decision-making. They must model data-driven decision-making and start implementing data-driven dashboards in their meetings instead of opinions to guide their decisions.
I want to put that on a t-shirt. Is that data or just your opinion?
Well, I mean, what I find so amazing are all the ways in which machine learning has been applied to all kinds of problems and industries. In Swami's keynote, we saw ML applied to the automotive industry to help reduce emissions, in manufacturing to improve the efficiency of making things, in healthcare to optimize hospital resources, and in payments, and even to help Australia's national swim team to swim even faster.
Another stunning example of ML changing industries is in transportation and, of course, autonomous driving. Chris Urmson, co-founder and CEO of self-driving technology company Aurora, walked us through how they are building autonomous trucks for carrying freight. And what is mind-blowing is how their Aurora driver can take on the hairiest driving conditions that most people have a hard time handling, like Rudy over here.
Here's an example of the Aurora driver operating in a monsoon rainstorm in Texas. This is an incredibly challenging scene. As you can see, there's a lot of rain on the camera lens, there's water being thrown up by the road, and there's heavy rain in the air. Despite all of this, the Aurora driver is able to drive safely down the road, even as other people, human drivers, are pulling off to stop. As you can imagine, making this work reliably is incredibly challenging.
It's clear that machine learning is becoming more and more a part of everything we do. And I was proud to see how we are bringing more and more people into the ML space and making machine learning more accessible to everyone. From scholarships that make it easy to get started with ML to the Deep Racer Student League, check it all out. And after we roll this clip, we have Mike Miller, GM of AI Devices, joining us for more.
Making ML more accessible to all is central to creating a more diverse and inclusive tech workforce. With that in mind, today we are launching the AWS AI and ML Scholarship Program, a new program that is supported by AWS, Intel, and Udacity that awards $10 million per year in scholarships and internships to prepare underrepresented and underserved students for careers in machine learning. Students from around the world have access to dozens of hours of free training and tutorials from AWS Deep Racer students. Then they can turn their theory into action. With this program, we will award 2,000 students scholarships to the AI programming with Python Udacity Nano program. Additionally, the top 500 students in this scholarship program will have access to mentorship opportunities from tenured Amazon and Intel ML technology experts. And any student who wants to test their models by racing virtual race cars in a competition can also join the AWS Deep Racer Student League starting in March 2022. We are excited about how Studio Lab, the AWS AI ML Scholarship, and Deep Racer Student will open up machine learning to a broader group of people and enable the next generation of ML developers.
Hi everyone, I'm Ryan Marine, and I'm excited to bring you the next evolution in racing, the world's first global autonomous racing league, AWS Deep Racer. In just a few moments, we will go live to the virtual track to find out who will take home the most coveted prize in machine learning, the AWS Deep Racer League Championship Cup, presented by Intel.
What an amazing opportunity. We're joined by Mike Miller, GM of AI Devices. Hey, Mike. We heard from Swami in his keynote about some of the opportunities to introduce more people to machine learning, including scholarships and the Deep Racer League. Let's dig a little deeper into all of that. So starting with the scholarship program, who can join, how, and what are they going to learn?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, thanks, Rudy and Melissa, for having me on the show. I'm really excited to talk about the AWS AI and ML Scholarship Program that we're in collaboration, presenting in collaboration with Intel and Udacity. So the scholarship program, as you heard Swami mention, is available for students, high school and older, 16 and older, who are interested in machine learning careers. So the scholarship program combines over 20 hours of free content along with the AWS Deep Racer League and a student-only version of the AWS Deep Racer League to provide over 2,000 scholarships for online Udacity Nano degrees.
Wow, I mean, look, amazing. That's fantastic to hear. And one of the points that came through loud and clear in Swami's keynote is that machine learning, if it isn't already, will become part of how we do practically everything. So in that context, why is it important that we bring more people into ML?
Yeah, that's a great question. And it's something that Amazon and Intel and Udacity are passionate about. You know, we see AI and ML are going to be a part of virtually every industry over time. But today, there's not enough trained ML developers to meet that demand. And so what we're trying to do with this scholarship is educate, excite, and get more diverse people from underrepresented backgrounds in the ML world and into the tech world through this fun and hands-on kind of learning opportunity. Because really, the most innovative ideas are gonna come from the widest background of people from all walks of life. And so we wanna make sure we encourage those people to see a future in technology.
Great, I love that. Deep Racer, I want to race, and I want to race. Everyone wants to race. So tell us how students can take part in the league and unleash their inner Lewis Hamilton. If Hamilton drove a 1/18th scale car that drives itself.
Absolutely. So I've got one of our Deep Racer cars here. And so the Deep Racer Student League is a great opportunity for students at no cost to get started with hands-on learning. And so we combine that 20 hours of free educational content with both a cloud-based 3D racing simulator and this 1/18th scale car. So what happens in Deep Racer is students can log on, they can learn the fundamentals of machine learning, learn about reinforcement learning, which is a type of machine learning that a car can learn actually how to drive itself through trial and error in the cloud racing simulator. And then they can take that knowledge and download it to the car and watch the car drive itself around a track. So students can get started at deepracer.com. There's a student portal there. And again, they've got free access every month to train machine learning models and participate in the Deep Racer League.
Awesome. So to reiterate, how do students take part in the scholarship program in Deep Racer?
Yeah, absolutely. So students can sign up when they access the Deep Racer student portal. And the scholarship is based on a few criteria to qualify. So students have to complete quizzes through the learning chapters. They have to race their car in the Deep Racer League and earn a certain kind of performance lap time, and then write an essay. And then 2,000 students can qualify for online nano degrees from Udacity, specifically the Python programming for machine learning nano degree. And then of those 2,000, the top 500 can qualify for an additional nano degree, extra mentoring support from Amazon and Intel executives, and additional opportunities through career fairs and other mentoring to drive their careers in tech.
Incredible.
Oh man, that's amazing to hear, Mike. And I actually ran one of the Deep Racer booths a few years ago, so it was a lot of fun. But thank you again for being here, Mike, and telling us about all of these fantastic
Thank you for having
demo.
Me on. Yeah, so it was great.
There was another announcement yesterday from Peter DeSantis's keynote that I want to make sure we hit on. He updated us on AWS's plan to be running on 100% renewable energy by 2025, and everything is on track there. He also announced that AWS will provide our customers with the carbon footprint of their use of AWS services to support their efforts to meet their own carbon reduction goals. I have customers and that is like definitely top of mind for them, so that's amazing. A forecast will also be included that shows how our sustainability investments will lower the carbon intensity of our customers' workloads as AWS progresses towards net zero carbon. There's more to come here, but look out for the AWS Customer Carbon Footprint tool to be made available early next year.
Ah, so good to hear this. And what does it boil down to? Well, more data for our customers to make better decisions. So before we head off to Werner's keynote, let's have Swami bring the data team home.
And if I can leave you with one thing, it is this. A data-driven organization is imperative today and for the future of your organization. It is the difference between the companies that will just survive or those that are going to thrive. So no matter where you are today, whether you're still using on-prem data centers or you've already started with your ML journey, you need a data strategy that works not just for what it is now, but also what you need for the future.
To the future.
Oh, I can tell you what is in my future. Replay. To get in proper frame of mind for re:Invent's biggest party, let's look at the top 10 moments.
Dodgeball, you are going down, Chetty.
Bring it on, ketchup.
Okay.
Well, I'm Rudy Chetty, this is Melissa Perrin-Cherrell, and you're watching live from reInvent.